Hi, welcome to our first video. My name is Álvaro Ribeiro, I'm a 3D artist, and I've been working as a sculptor for the past years for big companies like Prime One and XM Studios, doing statues like this.
Hello, my name is Márcia Georgina. I've been doing oil painting as a hobby for a while, but I found my real passion painting statues and miniatures. For the past year, I've been painting most of Álvaro's personal projects and doing some freelance for collectors. It has been a great experience, and I hope I can share a lot of cool techniques with you.
We really love what we do, but the projects we like the most are the ones that we have total freedom to create our own characters. With this in mind, me and my wife Márcia decided to create a new project called Loot. Our goal is to share a lot of cool content with you about 3D printing, 3D sculpting, miniatures, statues, everything about this universe.
This first video will be very cool and I'm sure you will like it. We will share all the process of creating this cool troubles from the 3D sculpting, passing through the 3D printing and showing the painting process.
And make sure to watch the entire video, because at the end, we will give you an awesome gift. So, let's do it! Everything starts here in the computer. The software I use is called ZBrush. It is very used for creating characters for games, cinema and statues. I start every project with a very simple shape, like a sphere. And it is very similar to sculpting with real clay. I can pull, push, add more clay, create holes. And with some simple steps, this sphere starts to look like a head. And to help me to have more precision and also pressure sensibility, I use this pen tablet. It is more comfortable than using a mouse and my sculpture gets better. And now you will see the full sculpting process, which took a few hours in just a few seconds. At first, I just had this idea of sculpting a troll, but with nothing very specific in mind. I wanted him to have a lot of personality, like a nice guy, not just a very bad troll. So I gave him this expression, this pose, like he's thinking about his life. I start sculpting basic shape and forms, the details come only at the end. He is a fantasy character, but even so, it is very important to know and respect the human anatomy. And now I'm giving him some accessories so it doesn't look like he's naked. And now at the end I add all the smile details that will make this piece very detailed, like skin textures, fabric textures, scars. Also the colors are just for reference, they don't come out after the 3D printing. And here is the final result of the 3D sculpting. At the back of the base I added this small Loot logo. Pretty cool, huh? At this stage, the sculpting is complete, but the file is very big. It has millions of polygons. So I have to make it smaller before I export the STL file. Once it is done, I have one more step before I start the 3D printing. I have to prepare and slice this module for my 3D printer. In this case, I'm using this software called Sculpt. First, I will put this bust in the right scale. Then, I will make it hollow and add a few holes. This way, the model won't be solid. It will be like a shell. And I will save a lot of resin, which isn't very cheap, right? I made this model very solid, so it actually doesn't need any support. But in the inside, I thought it was a better idea to add some. Now that the model is ready, I have just to slice it before I send to my 3D printer. Once it is done, I have just to save the file in my pen drive, so I can take it to the printer. For this model, I'm using my Frozen Sonic Mini. It is a resin printer
with a very low price and very high speed. This printing took around 9 hours, because the model is pretty big and I'm using 30 nanometers layer highs. In this stage, the printing is already solid, but the resin is not completely cured, so it is still toxic. Because of that, I'm wearing gloves all the time. Here you can see the liquid resin coming out of the holes. It looks like the printing came out perfect. Now I'll do the cleaning process. As you could see, there is still a lot of uncured resin around the model. For cleaning it, I'm using isopropyl alcohol. In this first step, I'm removing only the excess of resin. For removing the model from the build plate, I'm using this metal scraper. As I printed the model directly to the build plate, it is a little hard to remove. But with a little patience and a lot of strength, I could do it. Now our troll guy will take a bath. This is actually isopropyl alcohol again, but this time I'm using this ultrasonic cleaner. Usually it is used for cleaning electronic pieces, but it is very good for cleaning models printed with a resin printer. It takes just a few minutes and makes the details even sharper. As my cleaner is very small, I have to flip the model. After the alcohol starts to evaporate, we can see all the details, and they look very, very good. Look at this quality, it looks amazing. To help the alcohol to evaporate, sometimes I use the hair dryer. Even so, the model looks finished, the resin still uncured and toxic. So, to finish the curing process, I'll use some UV lamps. Time to get a tan. After an hour or so, the model is finally completely cured, so I can touch it with my hands. But it has some small things to fix. And also, I have to close the holes, of course. But rather than that, the print came out perfect. The quality is really amazing, guys. This printer is very, very good. I'm not sure how it's called, but I'm using this paste to fill all the gaps and holes. And also, I'm sanding a few parts. It looks very nice. My job here is done. Now, Márcia will take care of our troll model. I'm sure she will do an amazing painting job.
Let's go! I used acrylic paint of Liquitex and Vallejo brand. First, I will prepare the boost to receive the painting applying primer. I start applying the main color on each of the parts, skin, clothes, and fabric around the arm. Next, I use the technique called dry brush, in which details and volume are intensified by the lighter color. Using the dry brush and the whole piece brings forth the details. After that, I add more tones, mainly on the skin, reds and browns, then shading to create the effect of volume. I also increase the lights in some regions. I do the eyes and teeth in layers, waiting to dry, and finish with shine. to give a wet look.
So that's it, guys. Here's the result of our work. We did this nice straw bust, and this figure is the first of many. So let's talk about the gift I promised. If you want to print the straw bust I sculpted, you can download the STL file for free. There is a link on the description below. You have just to click there, put your email, and you'll get all the files immediately.
And there is more. We will also get a complete video where I show more details about the painting process. This way, you can print and paint this model at home.
If you do it, please share with us. Post your troll bust on Instagram and tag us at loot.studios. We'll be very happy to see your result. We hope you liked this video. So please, comment below, give us your feedback, and don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell so you don't miss any of our videos.
Bye bye, see you in the next one.